Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, depending on where you are in the world, and welcome to the talk, A Flexible Dry ECG Patch for Heart Rate Variability Monitoring. I am Miraj Ahmed from IIT Bombay. The overview of the talk will be as follows. We'll start with the motivation, then we'll talk about ECG patch, hardware, electrode fabrication process, measurement results, and then conclude the talk. Now the motivation. Cardiovascular diseases, in short CVD, are the number one cause of death globally. An estimated 18 million people died from CVD in 2016. High blood pressure, physical inactivity, smoking habit, diabetes, and unhealthy eating patterns are main risk factors associated with CVDs. Heart rate variability, in short HRV, is a useful quantitative indicator to assess and prevent some of the cardiovascular disease. HRV refers to the continuous heart rate or continuous R to R wave intervals extracted from electrocardiogram, in short ECG signal. For continuous and long-term heart rate variability monitoring, a flexible dry ECG patch is required. Flexible and dry. These two factors we have focused more considering the user comfort. Therefore, the flexibility should be in terms of hardware, means the PCB, as well as flexibility in terms of electrode. The block diagram of the flexible ECG patch is shown. It has three important modules: ECG signal conditioning module, then wireless MCU module, and the power management module. We'll start with ECG signal conditioning module. The ECG front end, ADS1293 IC from Texas Instrument. This IC acquires the weak differential biopotential signal from the body using LA and RA electrode. The third electrode, RLD, right leg drive, is used to bias the body. The ECG front end also amplifies this differential potential and digitize the ECG using 24-bit ADC. The wireless MCU CC2650 from Texas Instrument is a controller and it has a RF module. Here we have configured it for BLE, Bluetooth Low Energy. Using SPI, the digital data from the ADS1293, the ECG front end, is read and transmitted to laptop or mobile using Bluetooth Low Energy. In power management module, we have TLV70433. It is an ultra low current LDO and a rechargeable cell, LIR2032. This is used for the power management. The developed flexible ECG patch on polyimide substrate is shown in this slide. The dimension of the patch is 5 cm cross 5.5 cm. The front side of the patch contains all the electronics components. You can see this CC2650 wireless MCO at the bottom. In the bottom left, we have the cell holder. In the center, we have this ADS1293 ECG front end IC. On the top left, we have LDO TLV70433 and a switch. The left arm LARA and RLD electrode, the connection is made through these three vias on the top side. On the rear side, we have three screen printed electrode of diameter 1 centimeter. These vias on the top connects to these three electrodes. The three electrodes, the bottom, the middle electrode is the right leg drive electrode, and the other two are LA and RA electrode. Now we'll see the electrode fabrication process. Using screen printed method, the three electrodes, LA, RA, and the right leg drive, RLD electrodes, were fabricated. And the fabrication process is shown in this slide. First, a paper stencil is used to create the mask for the electrode. This paper stencil has one side sticky, which can, after patterning, can be sticked to any substrate or surface. Then a circular disc pattern is made on this stencil with a laser cutting tool. Then this mask is stuck to the rear side of the PCB, that is the polyimide flexible substrate. Finally, carbon ink from Dicotech material was used to coat the exposed part to form the electrode, and the stencil was then removed. The sensor was then heated in the oven at 70 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes for curing. ECG recording. The flexible ECG patch was placed on the chest in close contact with the skin without use of any gel, as shown in the figure in the left. A hook and tape belt was used to strap the patch on the body. A 20-second data is recorded using the patch on the laptop through Bluetooth low energy. Using this data, we calculate the heart rate variability. We'll now see how it is. The heart rate variability from ECG. The time difference between two successive R wave peaks from the ECG signal are extracted from the captured ECG signal for heart rate variability analysis. As we can see in the graph, with time, the time difference to R, the time variability from peak to peak is observed. This information is very critical in predicting the cardiovascular diseases. So based on this data for long-term measurement, we can a priori, or we can detect some disease before it can be deteriorate a person's health. Now the ECG patch battery usage. In this patch we have used a 40 milliamp LIR2032 rechargeable cell. So two experiments were performed, first in a continuous mode and in one in a duty cycle mode. In continuous mode, the ECG patch was extracting the ECG signal continuously and transmitting via Bluetooth to a laptop. And in duty cycle mode, in every 15 minutes, for 20-second ECG signal was extracted and transmitted. With this duty cycle operation, we got a lifetime of battery of 10 days. With this duty cycle operation is sufficient for heart rate variability operation. So now we'll conclude. So first, we have designed and developed a flexible dry ECG patch for heart rate variability analysis. The hardware for the ECG acquisition was implemented on a flexible polyimide substrate. Dry electrodes were screen printed on the same polyimide substrate for ECG acquisition. Data recorded from the flexible dry ECG patch was presented, which was used for HYV analysis. Thank you for